going to speak for a couple of minutes in Bangla first. Amar Rohingya bhai bon jara achen choriye chite shunchen nana jaygar theke apnader shokoler sathe ami shonghoti janiye shuru korchi. আপনাদের পাশে আমি আমরা আছি যতই আমাদের বাংলাদেশী সরকার বাংলাদেশী রাষ্ট্র যতই আপনাদের স্মৃতি এবং আপনাদের ইতিহাস ভুলে যেতে চায় মুছে যেতে চায় আপনারা মনে রাখবেন যে আমার মতো মানুষও আছে বাংলাদেশে আপনারা যাতে মানুষ হয়ে বাঁচতে পারেন মানুষ হয়ে অধিকার রাখতে পারেন তার জন্য আমরাও সংগ্রাম করছি ওকে আমি এখন বাকিটা ইংরেজিতে বলবো I spoke here last year, and here we are again. And as somebody who is from Bangladesh, who isn't an active advocate in that sense, who is a scholar, who's had to confront the Rohingya issue because I'm from Bangladesh, it's a little bit hard to know what to say that will be meaningful anymore, because so much has been said and written on the continual genocidal violence and dispossessions, on the failures of the international community, on the weaponizing of war. I could go on, and I'm confronted with old questions about solidarity. What does it mean 4 years after, and not just 4 years, many, many years? And what do we do with our government's complicity? The events, Afghanistan has come up, and you know, for me, Afghanistan has been very much on my mind as I thought about today, because the way in which events have unfolded in Afghanistan and the way in which events have been narrated about why we are where we are in Afghanistan has reminded me of how critical the theme of the event is on the politics of remembering, on forgetting, on the silences and silencing of history. What we see in Afghanistan, it's a reminder of how some histories of violence have been very selectively invoked and others of imperial violence have simply been erased. As the international community, as other people have said, to work one more on these very tired responses to refugees, which may or may not go anywhere, as we know. So I think refusing to remember the very long histories that make genocides or genocidal conditions is really, really important if we want to move forward. And this refusal to remember is not just on the part of the Myanmar state, but also the Bangladeshi state, as several of the speakers have spoken to, because we know about how the Bangladeshi state is now basically clamping down on any kind of referral to the past, any kind of remembering. It wants to forget. We've heard about the rallies in the camp that were closed down, the big commemoration 2 years ago, and the consequences Rohingyas in camps face. Last week, I heard the T-shirts that were printed to commemorate the genocide were confiscated again by Bangladeshi authorities. So there is a very, there is an effort, and it's not just by the Burmese government, it's by the Bangladeshi government to silence and to have history written in a certain, thought about in a certain way that makes it easier for the government to make certain political decisions. And even the government is constantly not naming the Rohingya in the agreements that it has with the Myanmar government. The Rohingya are not named as such. So Rohingya subjectivity is extinguished even as they are trying to force the Rohingya back. I just want to say that there people have spoken about justice and accountability. And what we see in Afghanistan is that because there's such a narrow focus on a particular kind of violence, there is no justice, there's no accountability for what happened in the 20 or 40 years before. And we don't want that to happen. I think if we want to move forward, we have to have a reckoning with the past and with the politics, with Rohingya stories of their past. Okay, so we in Bangladesh have to push back against the selective forgetting, but also the dehumanizing of the Rohingya being and subjectivity that has continued in the camps in various ways from Bangladeshis too. I mean, it's really not just we from Bangladesh cannot simply, you know, demonize the Burman other. It's we Bangladeshis, we're complicit in that. And we have to start naming that history and not giving in to our governments. Thank you.